are old customs that protect the traveling priests of the All-Mother. The one you see before you, walking through the weirdness at a brisk, confident pace, doesn't seem to realize or care that this protection is unlikely to extend here. Before you have a chance to ask her for anything, something leaps out of the weirdness.
Praise the Mother. I'm glad you're here. I want to settle this once and for all. If All Mother is still with us, she will protect me. If not, I'd rather die anyway. Now let me be on my way and you go on yours. With my blessing. I'm too far away from the altar to cast spells like that. I can give you some potions or teach you a certain technique, though. It's your choice.
You enter an old cemetery. It reminds you of more peaceful times, when people had the luxury of burying their dead properly and returning to pay their respects. However, the cemetery is not a place you should linger, especially this close to the weirdness. As you walk through the cemetery, you hear the unmistakable sound of a spade biting into the earth. And you hear something else, too. Weak, helpless begging.
No, friends, please, it wasn't me! It wasn't me!
Even in these cruel times, burying someone alive is an unconscionable act. What on earth could the victim have done to deserve such a fate?
How dare you butt in? And why do you care anyway? Just let us finish the work.
Please! No! You don't understand! It's not what you think! Please! Fellas!
Shut your mouth!
The unfortunate soul in the grave cries out in agony as the men strike him with shovels. give a helping hand to the would-be victim. He crawls out of the grave.
Thank you. Thank you, warrior. If it weren't for you, I would rot here till the end of time. They keep burying me. On and on. I don't know how long to keep the... I don't know how long this kept going on. Them. Oh, right. They were brothers of my... They were brothers of my sorely missed fiancé. She didn't want to marry me, but she got pregnant. So she had no choice. The thing she gave birth to, though... I had no choice but to get rid of them both. There was no point in working my ass off to feed a hysteric lady and a three-armed baby girl. But now, thanks to you, I'm finally able to find myself a brand new bride. Lovely and devoted, as I deserve to have.
Before you react, he bows to you and disappears into the darkness. Somehow you feel that you will see him again one day. You find an elderly archer sitting near a small fire. He tends the flames with care and tenderness.
Oh, a visitor. I haven't seen a friendly human face for a long time. It's getting lonely out here.
With a gesture, he invites you to sit with him.
Beautiful, isn't it? The question shouldn't be who I am, my friend. The question should be who I was. Because right now, I'd say I'm pretty much nobody. Not much. I tend to the fire and watch over this place. Since I fail to fulfill my task, I need to sit here and watch the fire. I don't want to, but I have to. I'm certain something terrible will happen if I stop. Well, that's definitely a story for another time. But I do appreciate you asking.
As you sit by the archer, you notice that this fire doesn't behave like a regular fire. It has the power to push weirdness away, just like a menhir or a weird candle. Moreover, you suddenly notice that the man's legs are rooted into the ground with blue veins. The veins stretch from his feet into the fire pit. You form a question in your mind, but when you look into the man's eyes, you realize there's no point in asking it. His gaze is absent, and his movements are barely noticeable. You decide to leave it for another time and turn your eyes towards the fire. The flames flicker with a weird, magical rhythm. These crystals were already...
regardless healing.